हेलो फ्रेंड्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल एंड डूइंग गुड। वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। आई एम प्रीति। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल थैंक यू फॉर शावरिंग सच अ नाइस रिस्पांस एंड लव टू माय चैनल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट मेरिट्स ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी ओवर ट्रेडिशनल मेथड ऑफ हाइब्रिडाइजेशन एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ फर्स्ट आर्टिफिशियल रिकॉम्बिनेंट डीएनए। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर टॉपिक। As we all knew that hybridization is the process of combining two single standard DNA or RNA molecule and thus allowing us to form a single double standard molecule through base pairing, and this procedure is used in plants and animal breeding program. Here the major limitation of hybridization is that it leads to the multiplication of undesirable gene along with the desired gene. Biotechnology overcomes this limitation as it involves the construction of artificial recombinant DNA and use of gene cloning that allow us to isolate and introduce only sets of desired gene into target organism. The first artificial recombinant DNA was constructed by Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer in 1972, and it was achieved by linking a gene that encodes for antibiotic resistance with the native plasmid of Salmonella typhimurium. Here you can see in the diagram that with the help of the restriction enzyme, a portion of the DNA that encodes for antibiotic resistance gene was cut out, and this cut portion was then linked with the native plasmid of Salmonella typhimurium with the help of the DNA ligase enzyme. This plasmid will become genetically modified plasmid, which is then transferred into the E. coli, where it gets replicated using the host DNA polymerase enzyme. This ability to form multiple copies of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli is also called cloning ability of antibiotic resistance gene in E. coli. I'm ending this video now. In my upcoming videos, I'm going to cover nucleases under topic tools for recombinant DNA technology. Please subscribe my videos, share them with your peer group and like them. Good day. Bye-bye.